Gamers, today we're going to be playing a little bit of Wooden Battles, and in this video we have a Steam Workshop mode called Zombies. And what that is a large base defense here with musket troopers defending a minefield, and it looks like the survivors stacked the mines a little strangely there. I don't know what's up with that. As well as some Gatling guns, cannons, you know, the whole nine yards, even some snipers up in the towers defending against zombie spawners. Zombies are going to be coming out of here and attacking the survivor defenses. There are a few survivors that will go and attack the zombies too, but for the most part, it will be a defense. It should be awesome. If you guys enjoy these Wooden Battles videos, please be sure to hit that like button, subscribe if you have not already, and comment down below what you'd like to see in the future. Either way, let's get into the zombie defense. All right, let's see how this goes. Pressing start, and we got ourselves some Zumbos coming up, which are essentially the swordsmen in blue. So about as close to zombies as you can get in this game. I really wish this game did have mods. I think that would just take it to the next level. Imagine actual zombies in this game fighting against wooden soldiers. It would be amazing. But instead, you know, we're making do with what we got. We, you know, it's pretty creative to have the blue swordsmen be the zombies. It's about as close as you get. So either way, the troopers that sallied forth for the reds are just about all butchered, and now the zombies are moving on forward. However, the minefield is getting in their way. Oh, I want to see this big tower of mines blow up. Oh, it's going to be glorious. One of them did, like the bottom one did. I wonder if, like, they step on this and, like, all of them blow up, or I don't know how this thing is going to blow up, but I'm very excited to see how it does. Either way, the reds are doing just a bang-up job here, taking out the blue zombies as they move on forward. It's really not much of a competition as of yet. The blues are just getting absolutely stomped on, but with unlimited zombies coming forward, eventually they got a win, right? Oh, the reds actually have sniper reinforcements coming in. I never noticed that before. Okay, so the reds actually get sniper reinforcements, but it looks like part of the wall crumbled on top of them, so a lot of them died, which is kind of weird. Oh, there it goes! The Tower of Mine explodes! Let's go! That was my favorite part. Yes, it continues to. All right, the Tower of Mines was epic. I really like that. Here come the blues now, actually destroying the game. Oh, there's more spawners over here for the reds. And there's swordsmen, and they just keep falling to their death. What is this map? This is such a weird map. All right, very peculiar. Honestly, I feel like this same idea could be done better again in a more sort of standard fortress defense type of a thing. I think this one is definitely a little bit scuffed, and it could have been made a little bit better. I really like the concept of the zombies coming forward and attacking the reds and things like that, but again, it's just a little too scuffed. Like, it's weird that there are reinforcements being spawned in. I feel like it would be better if this was just like a pure defense and there were no reinforcements being spawned in for the defenders. I think that's just a little bit peculiar and strange. But, you know, other than that, it's a fun concept. I am enjoying it. The rest of the zombies just kind of marching on in here. The reds not really standing much of a chance. Look at that, the zombies getting all the way in here. These reds popping up and dropping down because there's actually no room for them to really spawn in anymore. There's just so many bodies that they're just dying, boys. Either way, here come the zombies killing the last of these snipers over here. There's some musketeers up here that are just kind of trapped, surrounded by zombies here. There's not a ton they can do. This actually looks super cool. I like this a lot. This is very epic. It looks cool getting surrounded. It's very World War Z-esque, you know what I'm saying? World War Z? Yeah? Plan Z? Plan Z will never fail. Oh, they're getting What? They're getting carried away like ants carrying little logs or something. Sticks. They're going with them. They're just on top of their heads. And they're not dying either. Oh, let's clear bodies 1 second. That's going to clear up the lag. Yeah, there we go. So much less laggy. The blue team wins. These guys are still alive, though. Oh, but they captured the flag. That's so funny. They end up, like, riding the zombies' heads. All right, guys. Well, that was a pretty fun battle. But why don't we get some more fun going here in Wooden Battles? All right, this next map is literally just called War. Like, War exclamation point. Doesn't get much more basic than that. You know, like that song, War. What is it? Yeah, okay, let's get going here. We don't need to hear me sing. Either way, here we go. Just two. Oh my god. It's even lagging the sound. I just... All right, you know what? It was an apt title for this battle because this is indeed quite the war. It's just bombastic All right, let's clear bodies. Wow, that was some lag. All right, what a start to this battle. That's crazy. I even have a good computer and that was crapping out on me a little bit there. Holy cow. Either way, both sides do have reinforcers, I believe. Yes, the reds have one reinforcement block that spawns in swordsmen, but the blues have three, one of which spawns in bayonet chargers, one shotgunners, and one standard rifleman. So I will definitely say that the blues have far superior reinforcements to the reds here, which could easily result in a blue victory. I mean, all it takes is the reinforcements to be better, and you know, a defense will crumble. That's just a plain old factual right there. Either way, here we go. The musketeers going in deep, shotgunning these fools. Nope, they're dead. They are gone. All right, well, these two are going up against an entire... they're all gone. All right, maybe facing an entire lineup of rockets is not exactly the easiest thing to do, but, I mean, look at all these snipers over here. They should be taking out these artillery pieces lickety-split. Come on. It doesn't take that many shots to kill these things. Focus up on them. Come on, boys. Come on. Blues, you got the reinforcements to win this thing, but right now you are choking it completely and wholeheartedly. The Reds do have a number of medics over here, though, all healing their own snipers. So this could be a massive problem, actually, for the Blues. That could be a huge oof right there. Let's go ahead and clear bodies again, just to claim back our FPS. It's really funny. We were at, like, 50 FPS right there, and now we're at 200 FPS after clearing up those bodies. So definitely worthwhile right there. That is worth it for sure. What I think is happening right now is, despite the Blues having the better reinforcements coming in, the Reds currently have the defensive advantage, plus their reinforcements are actually distracting the blue reinforcements. So the blue reinforcements are coming in and only attacking the red reinforcements, and they're not taking care of the red defenses. I also don't understand how these snipers have not finished off these artillery pieces. They have free reign on these guys over here, and they are doing nothing. All right, let's clear bodies one more time right here. Why don't we go in fast motion here just to see what ends up happening, because despite me thinking that the Reds were definitely going to lose this, the Reds are actually putting up an amazing fight here. Their artillery is just absolutely killing the game right now and the enemy. And the snipers back there just getting healed and doing everything they can. I mean, currently this is looking like it will end up being a red victory. But then again, you know, those reinforcements for the Blues are so significantly better than the red reinforcements that, you know, I feel like after a certain amount of time, the Blues will win. Let's go ahead and clear bodies one more time here. How are these artillery pieces still up? There's only one left, but still. Okay, there we go. Those things lasted forever. That was absurd. So now the Blues get to go up against the snipers here, and actually the snipers and medics fall very, very quickly right there. And now it's up to the Blues to go up against this staggering defense up here. We got snipers on the walls up top firing away down below and just smashing it. We've got mortars back here, although the mortars will run out of ammo, so that's not going to be a long-lasting thing for the Blues to deal with, but it will definitely get some kills. Mortars are not like artillery where they have infinite ammo. They will run out of ammo and just explode because of that, which is kind of weird, but whatever. The Gatling guns won't, though, and the Gatling guns are on the field doing some stuff, but the Blues now are just getting a grip on things. They are finally managing to actually persevere here, get forward, and get the kills that they need to win this battle against the red defenses. Here we go. Yep, big bayonet charge right there from those blue soldiers. The musketeers still firing away. These red snipers really need to be taken care of, but the Blues really seem to be focusing in on these spawners right now, and who can blame them? It's just such a prevalent, attacking force from the Reds. They charge right on forward. You kind of got to kill them before they get too much in your face. Let's clear bodies here one more time. So what do the Reds have? I think the Reds literally only have the spawner here. So the Blues simply need to kill these guys and then come forward to capture the flag. Oh no, there's one musketeer in there, but he did end up dying pretty quick there. Yeah, so the Blues just need to come in range of the thing, and there you go. They do it, and they do manage to get the dubski right there. Well done, Blues. You finally managed to get the win, but dang, did it take some time right there. All right, let's do one more battle here. Okay, so this one's called City Raid. I can't remember if I've ever played this one before. It seems familiar to me, but I literally can't remember. If we had played it, it's probably like a number of years ago we played this, so I suppose it's fine. It's basically like the city block right here with a ton of toy soldiers invading. So let's go ahead and see it. Oh, it's such a beautiful little cinematic thing right there. I love that. That's what I love about this Toy Soldiers game. It's very simple, but in that simplicity comes some beautiful cinematics that I just really, really adore. All right, let's clear bodies right away because it will get laggy if we don't. The red's just going all in on this charge, but I don't think they get reinforcements. No, they do not. So it is really up to them to manage to win this thing. Clearing bodies one more time just to keep the lag away. It's way more fun to watch these battles with good FPS. So there we go, toppling more fortifications here. Again, you know, this is it for the Reds. Unlike those previous battles where there were reinforcements coming in for the attackers, in this one, they've just got to make do with what they've got. So that makes it a lot harder. Look at these mortars just lobbing shot after shot after shot at the blue defenders here. That's going to be very, very helpful. Gatling guns getting nice and close here, rolling on up and firing away. Not a lot of infantry on the field, but a lot of heavy weapons on the field right now for the Reds. And it seems like that will end up winning them this thing. Well, hopefully. There is one musketeer like way up here. A couple more troopers over there too. But they're going to just go for the flag and secure the victory that way, which is definitely an easier way out than attacking those other guys. But I'm sure they would have won either way. Either way, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. That's going to be about it for Wooden Battles today. I hope you did enjoy. Please be sure to hit that like button if you did. Subscribe if you haven't already. And comment down below if you'd like to see some more in the future. All right, guys, I'll see y'all later. Peace.
I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Be sure to click that subscribe button for more content, and hit the notification bell if you'd like to be alerted to whenever I live stream or upload. Thanks so much!